Hello everyone, and welcome back to Mayhem Plays Minecraft, episode 2. Oops. Wrong button. Still wrong button. Still wrong button. I'm new to this game. Today we're going to try and work on our pier and fishing shack. And I figured I'd do this off camera, because this was a lot of really annoying water bucketing and building down. And I was annoyed watching it, let alone if y'all were watching it. Shh, I'm recording. Quiet. But anyway, guys. Alright, so I tried comparing colors to see what actually looked good. And I know the spruce looks like it might be a little funky to start out with, but just wait. It comes together once I have this. The oak wood placed incorrectly, because it's going to be one of those days. From the side, once you look at it, the spruce and the oak actually goes really well together. And since I've got the oak planks up there with the... I said fir last time. What I meant to say... because I forget this tree name every single time. Nope, still doing it. We're just gonna go with zebra tree. Since most of it is made out of this birch, I'm going to have to end up keeping one of those on me at all times, just so that way y'all stop laughing at me. Because for some reason it is the one word that does not stick in my head. But anyway, since most of it's birch and then there's a little oak, I wanted some contrasting colors. And the spruce and oak just go really well together. So I'm going to, of course, do that because it looks wet. But the stairway is just stairs down with upside stairs back, because otherwise I think it looks way too thin and just funky being connected at the corners. And see that pro jump? Mm-hmm. Parkour skills to the max. And I wanted it centered on this as much as possible. And that hole will lead out of the living room and I think go out to a small balcony that it'll make. We'll see. I thought about connecting a staircase from there down to here, but it just looks stupid since I already had that staircase. And since I like it to be symmetrical, there's two here, two blocks here, and then these three. So it's going to come down here and have a little spot, and then I want it to branch off into five wide, and I'll put a little fishing shack here on the side. And then, yeah, I'll see y'all back once I get that done, because it's going to be a whole lot of this. And especially this. So I'll see you guys in a minute. This was oh so tedious. But it came out looking, I would say, quite well. Alright, I ended up, if you notice over here, I actually raised it up half a slab, because when I went to try and do some creative lighting, well, the first attempt looked bad. It was like a kind of street lamp on here, and I just couldn't make it look good, so that was scrapped. I then decided to attempt to use glowstone instead, and that just looked bad being on this, being an entire block higher. And so I scrapped it all and raised the entire thing one or half a slab and came out with this. So it's got some nice lighting. The carpet on top is, I just think it looks better. It adds kind of a clean white fishing look to it. And over here is a spot for just a little fishing shack that will be purely for looks. And so I think it looks quite well. Indeed. And from the side, we've got baseboards or supports every four blocks, with the oak on top and the spruce underneath that go all the way down. I did not cheap out on it. And that's what was a lot harder than I thought, because apparently it gets really dark once you get down here now. Don't kill me. Okay, now we've got this. And, of course, since it's half slabs, mobs can't spawn on it. That's nice. What am I looking for? Aha, birchwood. Still have it. Let's pick up a few more of these. I'm trying to figure out if I just want it just a plain little square, or how. Thinking, obviously, some of it's going to have to get raised up. So maybe we should just misplace our blocks. I am so good at this game. Actually, yeah, maybe we can just bring the lights into this. Which means let's knock these out. And never ever get them back. We'll put water, put a door there. Let's put actually in these corners. Right. Yeah, because I don't want anything here to interrupt this line of lights. I think that straight line of lights looks really good. And just in case, I wanted to have a walkway around here. So yeah, this will work fine, I think. I don't even know how I placed that. Okay. And go on top. Y'all didn't see that. Just want a cheap little fishing hut or someplace to kind of store fishing rods out here so that way they're not clogging up other inventory spots. And now, what do I put in this spot? I'm trying to at least be a little creative. something. I don't know, should I just extend that up, I guess? Could just carry this up like that. That looks alright. Having the trees come all the way up like this Now those are half slabs, nothing's gonna spawn up there. And actually, I have these. Ooh, I wonder what that'll look like. If we had the redstone lamps here instead, just as a kind of note. Well, actually, crap. Now how do I hide the levers for it? Goes up top. I think these will stick out way too much. But since we're already up here, let's find out. Can I do that? No, I can't. It's a one and done thing. Oh wow, I'm really hungry. And out of bread. Yeah, that would look way too funky. But what if... I know, being crazy here, but what if we had the trees extended up on the sides, like so, and now that we've got that, what if then put the lamps up here? We hide the levers a little bit better, maybe? Or maybe they would even look kind of interesting this way? I mean, sometimes the levers can actually work in your favor. That's not bad. What if I... I'm thinking of giving it like a pointed roof kind of thing. Stairs, maybe? I'm gonna toy around with this and I will show you what I think looks at least a little passable, and I'll see you back here in a second, guys. Alright, it looks like I've finally decided on a roof design that actually looks decent. It hides the levers from the outside view, and if you're inside, well, I really don't care that much. And I know in the end it ended up looking more like... Well, the first design I had for the roof made it kind of look like a witch's hut, but hopefully this makes it look a little more unique. This, I'm going to have to live with, because it's not centered. I know. Oh, and what's this? Different colored logs? No. Crafting table. Let's see. Do I want a double door up front? Let's try adding this in first and see if that works. Can't have any windows on the front. The glass wouldn't connect well with the doors. I was gonna end up going with just an oak because it lightens it up a bit since everything else out here is dark. Now, are the doors gonna cooperate? No, they're not. Nope. Really? I feel like they were supposed to. Okay. So it works on that side, but not on this side. Dang it, Dinnerbone. Okay, we're just gonna look away from there and just ignore that. But I wanted some windows in here. Because if not, it was just going to get way too drab. So I figured block these around. You'll get the light coming from those, and you'll ignore the levers. Did I bring enough glass? Perhaps I did. 5, 6, 7. Woohoo! And there we have a fishing shack with a, we'll go with the word decent view of Mushroom Island and a farm thing there. Water. And my house. And now it's just for a few finishing touches. I know, laptop, you're not happy. So. Thought I was out of slaps for a second. Have a chest for fish and a chest for fishing rods or something. Up here, we have good old first catch. And dang, I should have brought a second one, could have put a pole, but I didn't. And to tie it all together up here, wish I were fishing. No, that looks weird. Let's try that again. How about this then? Since it's all off-centered. Ta-da! I'd rather be fishing. So we've got our stuff. Nah, chair wouldn't look good since it's all a little low. Could raise it up. Yeah, I guess that looks better. Have some chairs there. Because no one wants to be standing forever. And saving. And there we have it. Our pier with mood lighting. Our fishing shack, which I would say doesn't look too bad. I actually like the lights. It gives it a look like if you were coming in from the river or the ocean on your boat, it would give it some extra light. We've got these lights back here still showing off. Alright. Oh, I know what I forgot. I think I did this off camera. I raised up these so that way I could put the signs here. I encased these in signs. I thought it looked like a nice... Quiet, zombie, I'm recording. It looked like a nice little flower bed. And grew a bunch of carrots because I thought those looked better. Okay, I'm going to have to go find whatever's making noise in there one day. Up here, I added the new acacia logs because the gray with that, I think, really stood out quite well. And I think it looked a lot better than just these. Originally, here was where I was going to do that, but it's going to be the balcony. And still yet to touch the bedroom. So it looks like I have to sleep in the rain. Oh, trees have sprouted up. And that's my house. There was something I was going to show y'all. Let me go show you the item farm that I made really quick off camera also, because I was bored and didn't feel like recording another episode. I'll meet y'all right over there. And here we have my item farm. It is way out here in the... That was the wrong button. It's way out here in the ocean, and I will meet y'all again once I climb up there. I just thought it looked like a really interesting view coming in from both. So I'll see y'all once I climb this ladder really, really fast. And we have magically climbed up this really, really, really long ladder. This is Old Man Gramps. Old Man Gramps is the owner of the server. And surprisingly, the name doesn't come from Old Man Willikers. Out here, I did not come up with this design. I'm sure many of you have seen the design before from other guys. I'll link the video on YouTube that I found the design through, because I have no credit for building it. But offhand, I cannot remember the guy's name that I saw his video, but I will try and find it. So it's got, I think I moved it down 24 blocks because some stuff wasn't dying because of some weird reason. But it's got a decent spawn rate, and I've got the four hoppers, each leading into chests here. This fence is necessary for two reasons. One, because as I was constructing this, and I thought it was working great, I was standing here at this workbench, doing my stuff, when suddenly I heard this lovely little hiss behind me. And I just accepted my fate. There was no doing anything about it. Creeper exploded, blew up two of the chests, hoppers, in this little area. I luckily managed not to fall. But since then, we've had a fence. The other reason for the fence, which thankfully it's not happening at this moment, is witches. That's right, with the new 1.72 update, witches now spawn anywhere and everywhere, not just witch huts. And what that means is apparently they have more health than your average mob, so they don't die from this. So I've AFK'd here for a couple hours, such as Gramps here is doing, and have found myself staring at three witches just waiting right here to toss their potions straight. Oh, like that. Just straight into my face. No, don't heal yourself. So in the future, I'll probably drop this a little more to counteract them. Or I'll just add in some pistons on the side that I can activate to come in and crush them, because that gets really annoying. The other little thing is I'm trying to figure out, I might just add hoppers here in these corners, because every now and then stuff will sit on top of these chests in these corner pieces and not get collected. So I have to figure out a way to get around that. I mean, I could make the entire floor hoppers, but then I would need to build in a lower level so that way I could get underneath to the chests. This way is just simple, easy, and it's mostly effective. And of course, up there, I have the spawning pads. I almost just pointed to my screen with my finger, thinking, oh, y'all can just see this. Here are the 8x8 spawning pads, and this entire thing is enclosed, so that way it spawns day, night, whatever. The top is completely lit up, so that way the only place can spawn is in here. You'll notice we are 192 blocks up right now, so anything that could spawn down there will instantly despawn. So the only area in the entire or the only place in the entire area that mobs can spawn is right in those little spots. And they're then carried down by streams of water from here to there, and they fall down. And that is the tried and true practice. item farm. If you so desire, you could change it so that way they only fall 22 blocks. Yeah, 22 blocks, which would leave everything alive, and you could use it as your own XP farm as well, but I just chose to do the item farm because I really just wanted the gunpowder and bone meal. Oops, almost fell off and probably would have... No, I wouldn't die. I think that's the other main reason I build these out over the ocean, is because knowing my luck, even with the safety wall, since I'm such a rebel, I hop on top of this and would immediately fall to my death, guaranteed, if this was built above land. But alright guys, I think that'll cover everything for this episode. We got the pier and the fishing shack done, and I got to show off my item farm that I built. And, I mean, even Gramps enjoys it, so I'd say that's a win. So I will see y'all guys in the next video. Please feel free to like, subscribe if you enjoyed it, and spread the word. I love shameless advertising. Have a great day, guys, and I will see y'all in the next one. Bye-bye.